It broke. This place is hopping. What's up, machine freaks? I hope you guys are enjoying your day. If you're new to the channel, I am 3D Machines, aka Dalton. I try to make awesomeness every day. Today, I am at a drag strip in Maryland, I guess. Mike's car produces more smoke than my Duramax. It rolls more coal. I think Mike f***ed up his car.
Mike, what the hell happened?
That's something.
Supposedly his diff went. I can't really get under the car, so I can't really see. I can't really verify that. But, oh, that sucks. Like, it's still a wonderful event, it's just, it sucks for Mike. So what ended up happening?
Oh my god, I'm on the vlog. Yeah. What happened was, is that my diff is now broken. So yeah. don't be putting 1100 pound feet in your car, it's a terrible idea.
So now that street speed has blown up his Corvette, blew up the diff, whatever you want to call it, I'm just going to cruise around, check out what's here. I mean, there's a lot of nice vehicles, a lot of cool people, a lot of extremely cool people. I mean, I got out of my truck like as soon as I got here and there was like 10 people waiting around my truck, like literally. Man, so we got a shout out. These guys want to make a shout out.
We want to shout out Jake the Toilet Snake.
Jake the Toilet Snake.
And yeah. The Danger Ranger.
You want to be in the vlog?
Yeah. What's your plans on naming?
The Gator Project?
Yeah.
I don't know if I can tell these guys. I found my first real fan. That's awesome, dude. That's awesome. That's awesome. What's your name?
CJ.
CJ's the man. He's the man. Just got it in. He got it in before I did. And I bought like 12 of them. What the heck? And it's signed. Look at this. It added like 15 more horsepower to that shirt. It's really cool. You guys here are awesome. Thanks for saying hi. Looks like somebody else pulled the street speed. Oh, good. You like this thing? Purple, as you guys know, purple is my favorite color. The thing about this place is, like, I don't know if I fit in. I mean, all these trucks are too nice, all these cars are too nice. I have low standards. It's like, as long as the vehicle gets me, oh, there goes the Duramax. As long as something gets me from point A to point B without me dying, then I'm okay with it. But I mean, you got trucks blowing smoke. gross, dude. You got cars flying, and then you have cars braking. Wow. So I've had three common questions asked, and that is about the Gator, that is about the Duramax, and that is about Jake the Toilet Snake. I don't blame the third question. Jake the Toilet Snake is the man. Once the carburetors are done, it should be a go. Like, we should be able to start throwing the engine in the Gator, and then we'll deal with power and horsepower, and then we'll worry about the drivetrain and see if that can hold up. I mean, we're throwing 1,000 cc's in a what would be 12 to 15 horsepower Gator. You gotta keep that in mind. You might put something really powerful in it, but then you might have a weak link, like a differential. Shots fired. Another real machine freak. So question number two is about the Duramax. The Duramax is parked over here. Like I said, I can't race it, so people have just probably been going over here and taking pictures of it. It's next to the really, really expensive trucks, so I'm sure they see that first, and then they just, you know, stumble upon my truck. I mean, I hate to make the good vehicles look bad, but I mean, when you hit a pole, the detail that puts in is phenomenal.
There it is.
So I'm getting some advice from Michael. Greg pointed me to Michael. Greg's got this truck over here. Unfortunately, he had some engine issues. I'm having a couple engine issues, so Mike's gonna tell me what's up. Maybe what's up. We're gonna start here.
I think the pressure relief valve is bad on it, so we're gonna get rid of that, put a rail cap on it. That way it can't relieve the fuel back to the tank.
I tried to explain it as well as I could, and he said this, so hey, it's a start, and supposedly it's a cheap fix, right? What do we got? $30.95. Perfect, right in the 3D machine's budget. That's beautiful.
This is like a completely built bottom end, top end, triple turbo. Last weekend it ran a 10.03 at 140. And we made a couple changes, but the truck really hooked up on the track this week, and we had a little bit of a problem, and now it's got a hole in the side of the block.
Yeah.
So it's not very visible, but the piece of a cam, piece of a piston, piece of a rod.
So
they wanted to see the outside. They were like, I don't want to be inside anymore.
In layman's terms, a lot of money. A lot of money.
Yeah. This has the potential to be a 9-second truck. I mean, my best past 2 days is a 10-second, but it probably could run nines pretty
if it decided to stay together. Yeah.
I see fluid up there.
Yeah, this is all oil.
Holy cats.
Really, I just needed to change my oil, and I figured this was the best way to do it.
Very, very quick, but very expensive. You know,
yeah,
you
got exactly. So,
pros and cons, ladies and gentlemen.
If you want to like diesel stuff, come check out Greg Alvarella, Greg A. We do everything diesel performance, and we do all of our work ourselves. So this is my brand, Wrenchworks, that we just launched. So come check us out. We're a good time.
Nice to meet you, Greg.
Thanks, man.
That's how it's done.
He's already ready to take over the business.
I'm glad I came here, and I'm learning that I love this community. Like everybody gets along, everybody's nice, everybody knows each other. So it's cool to see how cool these guys really are. Like something that should be in the history books. I mean, look at all these people. Like, it's crazy. Nuts. You do not want to end the race day like this. Not like this. That's an expensive day at the track. I just left the event. I'm following these guys. We're gonna go get something to eat, I guess, and then just peace out, Girl Scout, I guess. But I did have an awesome time, and I met a lot of you and a lot of creators, so it was a blast. And I want to thank each and every one of you that said hi to me and shook my hand and asked me questions. I think every single person asked me about the Gator. Every single person. And it makes it clear to me that I have to work on the Gator. We're gonna work on the gator. Unlike this sign, I am not loving it. I unfortunately got separated from the group. My truck's acting up. I was going, let's just say, faster than I was supposed to. And then my engine screwed up. Just after talking with Mike and him directing me what part to buy, I think that part's screwing up still. I obviously haven't bought it because I just spoke with Mike. So I got separated. I stopped at McDonald's to get a snack, and then I'll get back on the road. And then Mike Street Speed sent me the direction to the place. So let's just say I'll have my appetizer all figured out. I should have bought a Cummins.